"Face Like a Gas Man's Mac" was one memorable verdict, along with "Face Like a Wet Monday" and "Face Like the Back End of a Bus." He excelled himself on the late Jeremy Thorpe, whose features he compared to those of a Pox Doctor's clerk. "I'm guessing perhaps that most people, like my father, only became acquainted with the pale, haggard, miserable features of Mr. Thorpe in the aftermath of the events described in A Very English Scandal, Sunday, BBC One. There were plainly some other sides to the man, as this brilliant oddity from Doctor Who writer Russell T. Davies demonstrates. Mocking Harold Wilson in the House of Commons dining room, charming the boots off the assorted coppers and guards at the Palace of Westminster, doing sprightly violin and piano duets with his mum, Thorpe Hugh Grant, had a panache we wouldn't associate with today's politicians. It's easy to wonder if a great statesman was really ruined by the prejudices of the age, but Davies doesn't go for such an easy version of events. If Thorpe was vulnerable because of being gay, he also homed in on those who were vulnerable themselves, or seemed it at least. He just got it wrong in the case of troubled young stable hand Norman Joseph Ben Winshaw, seducing him, setting him up in a flat, then swiftly tiring of his moods and demons. Without an awful lot of conscience searching, it seemed, he was happy to have Joseph threaten and silence, the rise and rise of Jeremy Thorpe being the only issue of importance. As this witty but thoughtful TV treatment tells it, though, a scandal always involves at least two people. And as the blackmailing, chaos-bringing, eternally returning Joseph Winshaw turns in a performance every bit as spiffing as Grant's Thorpe, the past plays into actors' performances and Ben Winshaw's recent role as the voice of Paddington Bear did here. Joseph come across like a dark version of Paddington, turning up all lost and cute with his little suitcase, not seeming to understand the world, but actually better equipped to survive than Thorpe himself. "He's not weak," Thorpe's pal Peter Bessel, Alex Jennings, pointed out last night, as there recent attempts to silence Joseph had founded. "He tells the truth. No one else does this. In this whole world, there's Norman, as tributes go, a one-off mastermind." BBC Two, presented by retiring sports legend John "Motty" Motson, was quite a peculiar idea. Motty took up the challenge with all his usual verve, but without the sheepskin coat, sadly, asking football-themed questions of a range of sporting folk. The result wasn't terribly exciting. It was more or less an open goal for fellow commentator Jonathan Pearce. We then had the odd spectacle of a man marking his retirement from a lifetime of sports presenting by awarding a trophy to a sports presenter who wasn't retiring. Things might have been perked up if Motty had given us one of his legendary quotes. Alas, he confined himself to saying Alex Scott played for Arsenal ladies, no matter how often she reminded him that the team was called the Arsenal Women's Football Club. Maybe, to resurrect one of his better lines, Motty already had the taste of retirement in his nostrils.